procedures shown may not be current or airline specific. Do not use for real-life flying. Welcome, today we are cruising at 31,000 feet when the master caution light illuminates. The pilot flying immediately states,
"My aircraft,"
which ensures aircraft control is maintained while the issue is addressed. On the first officer's side, anti-ice is illuminated on the annunciator panel. This lets us know that an issue to do with the anti-ice system has occurred outside our normal field of view on the overhead panel. The master caution light can now be cancelled to avoid a distraction to the pilot flying and to enable the pilots to be alerted to any further issues. Looking at the top of the overhead panel, the left side window overheat light is illuminated, while the green on light for window heat is no longer illuminated. Illumination of the overheat light occurs if the window temperature reaches 145 degrees Fahrenheit, 63 Celsius, or with a loss of electrical power. Having identified the problem, the pilot flying calls for the window heat checklist. The pilot monitoring checks to see if the checklist is on the quick reference card if applicable, then looks in the quick reference handbook, known as the QRH. The window overheat procedure is listed under W and takes us to page 3.3. The pilot monitoring then reads the checklist title and condition so the pilot flying can confirm if it is the correct procedure before it is run. This would sound like
window overheat checklist. Condition: a window overheat occurs. Do you agree?
If the pilot flying agrees it is the correct checklist, will respond,
"I agree."
The pilot monitoring can now perform the checklist. Step 1 directs the window heat switch on the affected window to be turned off. The left side window shows an overheat condition, so that is the switch to be turned off. The next step is to wait 2 to 5 minutes to permit the window to cool. After the time has elapsed, step 3 has the affected window heat switch turned back on again. Step 4 is dependent on the result from turning the switch on. Did the window overheat light stay illuminated or extinguish? If the light has extinguished, the checklist indicates to continue normal operation, and the four black boxes would complete the checklist with this path. However, let's follow the checklist for if the light is still illuminated, we would therefore be directed to step 5. Step 5 directs to turn the affected window heat switch back off again, with a note to limit airspeed to 250 knots maximum, below 10,000 feet. Finally, step 6 calls for both windshield air controls to be pulled, stating that this vents conditioned air to the inside of the windshield for defogging. The four black boxes indicate that the checklist for this path has been completed. The pilot monitoring lets the pilot flying know the checklist has been completed by stating,
"Window overheat checklist complete."
Please subscribe to learn of future videos when we'll cover more non-normal procedures. Thank you.